Dakle, evo nas u Galeriji kulturnog centra Sada, veliko zadovoljstvo da sa ovom izložbom započinjemo saradnju sa Galerijom Kranjčar iz Zagreba. Kustos izložbe i naš stari poznanik Mladen Lučić, istoričar umetnosti Mladen Lučić, ali posebno zadovoljstvo što su sva tri umetnika stigla iz Hrvatske i ovde su sa nama. Dakle, Martina Grlić, Đilto Bavčević i Vedran Petkov. So, dear friends, we are really very pleased that this exhibition of Croatian artists is actually realized for the first time with a very renowned gallery from Zagreb, that is Kranjčar Gallery, that is the beginning of our cooperation. The curator of the exhibition is our friend, who is really very devoted to the Danube Dialogues. So this is a special pleasure, Mladen Lučić. But the most important thing is that all three artists are today with us. So it is my pleasure to present Marina Grlić, Đilto Bavčević, artist Marina Grlić, artist Đilto Bavčević, and Vedran Petkov. I will ask Mr. Lučić to tell us about the concept and about the art of these three artists, and our dear interpreter Nela Rebić will help us to do that in both languages.
Dobro večer svima, drago mi je da se opet vidimo i nadam se da ćemo svi u buduće isto ovako gledati. Naravno, to su draga stara lica, a naravno mnogo novih koje pozdravljam i želim dobrodošlicu. I ukratko o izložbi, da, prvi put je suradnja u svakom sa Galerijom Kranjčar, Galerija Bel Art, Galerija Kranjčar, koji bi je vrlo značajne privatne galerije, jedna sa Novi Sad, jedna za Zagreb, koji rade de facto isti profil programa i jednostavno su se ovdje našli. Dakle, nisu prodajne, nego izložbene galerije i to je ta spona koji kolega.
Good evening. I'm really happy to be here and to see you again. I hope I will be seeing you in the future as well. I can see here among the audience some familiar faces as well as some new ones, and I welcome you all. This is a very significant cooperation. This is between the galleries Kranjčar and Bel Art. This is the first time that these two galleries, private galleries, cooperate, and we actually work on the same program. These are not profit-making galleries, these are exhibition galleries.
Tema ove izložbe je upotreba čovjeka. I sad mi je Sava Stepanov poslao tekst, sažetak, odnosno eksplikaciju teksta knjižnika koji je to napisao. Želio sam ilustrirati to, htio sam se prvi put u stvari držati striktno teme.
The topic of this year's festival is the use of men, the topic of this exhibition, and when art director of the festival, Sava Stepanov, sent me an abstract, a summary of the text of the author Aleksandar Tišma, I really decided to stick to the topic as much as possible.
Govorim o temi ne treba, to bi bilo jako, jako dugo. Uglavnom, upotreba čovjek je bila ostati svijeta i uvijek je jači, tlači ili slabije, ali ovo što se danas dešava sa korporacijama, liberalnim kapitalizmom i novim svjetskim poredkom, mislim da je perfidnije i licemjernije nego ikad u povijesti.
I feel that it's not necessary to discuss this subject, this topic. It would take a very long, long time. We all know that the use of men has existed since the Diluvian times. The stronger ones always try to subjugate the weaker ones. And however, I must add that the today's situation with all the corporations all the corporations, the liberal capitalism and the new world order is a system more cunning and more perfidious than ever.
Naravno da tom novom sistemu najviše smetaju individualci, a umjetnici su uvijek bili, jesu i nadam se ostaće jedni od najjačih individualaca u ovom zato jesu. Zbog toga sam pozvao troje mlađih umjetnika, mlađih i najmlađih umjetnika i da se taj svoj stav prema takvom odnosu iskaže. I to sam pisao namjerno na tri medija, na slikarstvo Martine Grlić, na kompjutersku instalaciju Vedrana Perkova i na video performans Džilu Davčević.
I think that the greatest danger to this system are the individuals, and we also know that that artists are among the strongest individuals. I hope that they will continue to have such strong individualities of the future, in the future as well. This is also why I decided tonight, this evening, to invite three artists, younger and the youngest, and I wanted them to share their views, to express how they feel about that relationship. I also decided to use three artistic media. These are paintings of Marina Grlić, secondly computer of Vedran Perko, and the third is video performance by Gildo Bačević.
Vratimo se temi, možda najbliža Aleksandar Pišmi, upravo Martina Grlić sa svojim slikama, jer ona slika ono vrijeme u kojem je on pisao, dakle radi se o totalitarnim režimima istočnom blokačnom pesmu ovdje iz Jugoslavije, koju Martina upotrebljava kao generacija koja to nije doživjela, nego putem svoje memorije predaje i dokumenta nešto o tome zna. Međutim, ono što je bitno je da je svjesna i da zna da idolopoklonstva, da masovni, da veliki diktatori postoje i danas, da su de facto simboli vrlo slični, vrlo različiti, ali da metoda ista. Prema tome ništa bitno se nije promijenilo i to je ono da su svojom memorijom i svojim sjećanjima Martina želi pretvoriti u sadašnjicu.
I would like to go back to the topic. I think that of all the three artists, the closer to the topic of Tišma is probably Martina Grlić with her pictures. She, in her paintings, talks about former totalitarian regimes of Eastern Europe, European bloc, specifically Yugoslavia. And she belongs to a generation which did not live through these totalitarian socialistic regimes. But what she uses is memories, documents, and she, in a way, speaks about that time, about idolatry, the concept of ideology and the system of values, and using the systems of that time, she evokes this recent past and shows us that symbols may be different, but the methods are pretty much the same. So nothing much has changed from that time.
Vedran Perko, to su radovi vama iza leđa. Radi kompjutersku generiranu sliku teksta deklaracije o ljudskim pravima, koji je najprevođeniji tekst na svijetu. Onda stvara radi binarni kod, onda ih pretvara u znakove i što dobiva, dobiva smetnju. Možda nove generacije ne znaju tu smetnju, ali mi stari znamo kad smo gledali analogni televiziju da je to bio redoviti problem da je nastao taj bijeli šuš, bijeli snijeg ili kako smo ga zvali.
And the work of anthropology is behind your backs. Is a bit different. What he does is a computer generated pictures and TV disturbances. He refers to one of the most widely translated documents in the world, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. He converts the text of the declaration into a binary code, and then he replaces the numbers with black and white squares. Maybe some of you don't know what it is like, you didn't live at that time, of the time of analogous TV, but it was a very regular program problem with our TVs back then. His work is entitled Disturbance, and these monitors show disturbances resembling to TV disturbances we had back then. They are called snow or the white noise.
Naravno da to metafora, aluzija na krivo tumačenje, kao što se naravno danas ti sve upotrebi kako žele, tako i moćnici tumače tu deklaraciju ljudskih prava, što nužno dovodi do smetnji, do konflikta u šumu, o čemu govori i Čeho Bančević, samo naravno na jedan drugačiji način. On najme govori, ako idemo opet na upotrebu čovjeka, idemo na onu priču kad je čovjek već ne zna više u stvari koje resurse da krene i krenuje naravno narušavati prirodu. Njegov video performans upravo govori o tome da moramo, ako želimo cijeniti sebe, moramo cijeniti prirodu, moramo je se vratiti i poštovati njena pravila, jer ta pravila su uopće ljudska prava.
As we can see, the Declaration of Human Rights is being largely manipulated, but in our times exclusively by corporate strongmen and moguls, and they use it as they please. Perkov poses these questions of man being reduced to a number of or a sign, and he understands it very well, speaking in the language of electronics. A similar is the question posed by Gildo Bavčević, who talks about the ruined relationship between man and nature, and when man does not know where to go anymore, which resources to use, he turns to nature and starts using nature. A man in this way ruins nature, and what the artist is trying to say is that if we appreciate, if we value ourselves, we must value nature as well.
Eto, toliko, pa nadam se da sam obrazložio svoju koncepciju i zahvaljujem još jedanput na posjeti, što se došlo u ovakvom broju, idemo dalje, danas i sutra, i nadam se i sljedeće godine ponovo na donatskim dijalozima.